Welcome to Survey of Music Technology. In this first set of videos, we're going to talk about what music technology is as a field, and we'll talk about the course and some of its expectations and the course structure. In this first video, we're going to talk about music technology and the course, and also say a few words about myself and my background in the field. Music technology is really interesting to me because it's really many different fields. In particular, it's both a creative practice, making music, and a technical pursuit. A research to develop new tools and technologies and algorithms to help us make and disseminate and understand music in different ways. It's an inherently interdisciplinary field. It brings together areas such as music theory and composition, electrical engineering, computer science, mechanical engineering, industrial design, psychology, and many others. Music technology is comprised of many, many different subfields. This is just a small sampling of the variety of areas of inquiry within music technology. We're not going to be able to cover all of these even in the course of this course, but we will touch on a number of them. And my goal here is really to look at whatever is bringing you to this course, whatever interested you enough to sign up. I want to help you deepen your understanding of that area of music technology, but also expand your understanding of the field and your skills within it beyond to some of these other areas as well. And so, building from that foundation of interest and background that you bring with you. I believe that you can use commercial production tools to make music, if that's your goal, that you can use them more effectively and you can create better music with them if you understand some of the fundamentals underneath their design, the way they're constructed, the way different parts of them work, and through that, their strengths and their limitations and ways to take advantage of those strengths and to work around those limitations. I also think it's important to understand the building blocks of these tools so that you can start to develop your own and create your own or collaborate with other people to develop new tools that bring with them radical new ideas about how we can make sound, how we can perform music, and how we can be creative. And so my goal here is to expand both your experience as a creative musician and your experience in the technical side of music technology, in your ability to implement these tools. And we do this through really approaching the course as a broad survey, looking at as many of these kinds of areas that were on the last slide as possible, and doing it through a largely hands-on approach, especially in modules 2, 3, 4, and 5, we're going to be composing music, we're going to be writing code, we're going to be building and creating things and not just looking at theory. Our focus is dual. We focus on using commercial production tools, mostly focused around DAWs, digital audio workstations. And we also look at programming through the Python programming language, looking at ways to develop our own algorithms and our own processes from scratch. We'll also take a look, as time permits, at some of the historical background behind the ideas that we're introducing and some of the aesthetic practices that have been historically important. I wanted to briefly talk about myself and my background in music technology. My academic degrees are all in music composition, but I've always been engaged in computer science as well. And I think my interest in music technology emerged gradually from early childhood, up to the present day, I suppose, as I started to realize how these two things could come together in ways that were meaningful for me. And for me, as a musician, my real interest is in using technology to look at the relationships that link composers and performers and listeners, the ways that they come together in collaborative musical experiences, and to see how technology can actually help transform those connections and change the ways that these entities collaborate with each other. I particularly use digital wireless networks like Wi-Fi and the internet and things like that, as well as ubiquitous mobile technologies like smartphones to help facilitate these new kinds of collaborations. And I also have a strong interest in languages for computer music, something that we'll be exploring as we get into the later modules in this course. Looking at how to create computer programming languages that help musicians make music in new and interesting ways, and to collaborate with each other in new and interesting ways. And I'm also particularly interested in the connection between music technology and computer science in an educational standpoint, and how the two can inform each other, how they can be kind of united in a curriculum to teach the two together. We'll get a little bit of a taste of that as well in the later modules in this course.